supply.
Philippine Energy Secretary Alfonso Cusi believes the country's transmission grid can be remotely controlled by foreign entities. The secretary's statement runs counter to an earlier categorical declaration from National Grid Corporation's technical experts that the power transmission system cannot be remotely sabotaged.
In this digital age, anything and practically everything is possible remotely.
The president of the National Transmission Corporation, which owns the assets being managed by the privately run National Grid Corporation, also questions the security clearance given to the president of the National Grid, who has the highest security code to access the power grid systems.
Is Anthony Almeida capable of holding the key? Ano yung karapatan na ibinigay sa kanya bukod sa naging presidente siya ng NGCP para siya ang may remote access?
During Monday's press conference, Secretary Cusi ordered Undersecretary Emmanuel Juaneza to lead a team from the DOE and Transco to inspect NGCP facilities. Juaneza immediately visited NGCP after the briefing with a letter demanding regular inspections and a system audit of the transmission agency.
It's not a one-shot inspection or audit. There will be an established frequency.
NGCP officials have received the letter but did not immediately commit to the demands of the government.
Susuriin namin mabuti yan at kung yan ay nasasang-ayon sa concession agreement, then wala tayong magiging problema.
NGCP spokesperson Cynthia Alabanza has also defended the granting of the highest security clearance by the company's president.
Kung hindi ho si Mr. Almeida na pinakamataas naming opisyal, sino ho kaya?
The NGCP reiterates no entity can sabotage or control the power grid from outside since the system has a separate and complicated security controls which cannot be accessed through the internet. Alvin El Chico, ABS-CBN News.